Welcome back to the mailbag of the Dean Show. With you, Dr. Bilal Phillips. And we'll try to deal with some of your questions. Question I have for you here today, or for me, answering for you. I just became Muslim a year ago, but still haven't established the five daily prayers. Well, actually, when you become a Muslim, you should need to start it right away. Unfortunately, sometimes people are a bit neglectful in this. You know, they take their time and said, okay, you got to learn some Arabic to be able to say the prayers and learn the movements, etc., etc. So it drags on. But actually, when you accept Islam, you should start praying immediately. The very next prayer or the prayer of the time in which you accepted Islam, you should go and pray it. You pray it along with other Muslims. And you start the process of learning, you know, that because that you need to be doing that right from the very beginning. So it doesn't drag on like what has happened with you. So, I mean, what you need to do, you need to go down to your local mosque, speak with the imam, get somebody to work with you, you know, on a daily basis. You come in for your daily prayers with those that you're able to pray in the mosque and, you know, work with some people. You need help. Try to do it on your own. It's difficult, and that's probably why you're where you are right now. So reach out, get help. The community is there for you, and I'm sure you'll easily find many people who would be willing to help you. You went on to say, I'm having a hard time adjusting my life. Okay, adjusting life. Since 20 years, you've been doing your own thing. Now you want to try to do God's thing. Okay, it's natural. Doing your own thing, you felt freedom. You do it when you felt like it. Well, now God's thing requires you to do things in an organized way. I mean, what we have to understand here is that what God asks you in your life is for your betterment. You know, it's God's thing. He's the one who's prescribed it, but it's really for us, because whether we do it or we don't, whether we adjust our lives to what God has commanded or not, this doesn't benefit God in any way. This is for our own benefit. So that's why it's important for us to work on getting online, getting in line, you know. So my advice is just to stop and think for a minute, you know, why is God asking me to do these things? Accept in your heart that it is for my own benefit. I need to do it, right? I need to do it because that's what's really right for me, you know. And if I'm going to be a Muslim, then I should be a real Muslim, not a Muslim in name, you know, as we have many Muslims in name who were born into Islam, or they accept Islam, but they accept the wrong Islam or wrong, you know, understanding of Islam. They want to do their own thing, like you've expressed, you know, you're faced with that struggle. We want to do God's thing. We want to do the right thing. So it's going to take a certain amount of sacrifice. And reality is that anything that's good in our lives, we have to work for, we have to struggle for, we have to make effort for. And the religion, the guidelines for the whole of our lives, naturally we're going to have to make some efforts here too. You know, if there's no effort involved, it's just a lip service, you know, we say, I'm Muslim, that's it, you know, alhamdulillah, wonderful. But we're not doing anything, then obviously we're not really practicing Islam. We're just talking Islam. So what we want to do is to make Islam real in our lives, you know, and to live the principles. So that's my basic advice. I would say to you, try to be around the Muslims, you know, because sometimes people accept Islam and then they, you know, are left on their own, or they go off on their own and say, okay, I'll deal with it. And, you know, and then they end up being surrounded back into their old environment, surrounded by non-Muslims who are not going to support and help you to grow in Islam. So that's why it's very important, you know, that you reach out, you be with the Muslims, you know, as the Prophet, may God's peace and blessing be upon him, had said that, you know, the community is like a flock of sheep together, where there are people guiding it, the shepherd guiding it. And that stray sheep, the one who doesn't stay with the flock and goes off, is an easy prey for the wolves. I mean, that's Satan. You know, you off by yourself, you know, Satan will get to you and mess up your good intention that you had in accepting Islam initially, and leave you hanging out there. You know, maybe you'll end up, you know, going back to what you were doing, and etc. So stick with the community. Very, very important. With that, my dear viewers, I hope this answer has help to enlighten you somewhat, and especially you who asked the question. I'm sure there's probably more like you out there. And we hope to see you at some other point in time in some of the other programs. You may write to me if you want further information also at bilal17@bilalphillips.com. I'll try to answer, you know, any further questions you might have. Otherwise, you know, you can visit my website and gather other information from there, bilalphillips.com. Okay, take care. God be with you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.